Hello once again to the SMC Journal podcast. I am Scott Moore, your host. Thank you for joining me. We are on a journey to upgrade my home lab. If you didn't see the last video that I put out, I'm going to put a link somewhere up here in the video for you to check it out. It's my upgrade on storage to the Synology 1823 XS Plus. It was a success. It's great. But we are only part of the way through the journey to create a 3-2-1 backup system. As a reminder, a 3-2-1 backup system is three copies of your data. Two will be on this on-prem on one site on two different devices with another copy of that off-site. So if something happens to the site that you're at, your house explodes, for example, then you have a backup copy of that. So we've created our initial copy on a Synology NAS that's almost 80 terabytes. I've got plenty of space. However, there's a portion of that that I would like to have another backup right there on site in the same place for critical files. Now, not every file needs to be backed up to this. It would just be documents, you know, work items, pictures, things that are irreplaceable. In order to do that, I thought the simplest way would be to add an external USB drive to the Synology drive, Synology NAS. And that was actually very simple. I was using a existing Seagate external USB drive that I already had, just plugged it into the back, plugged it and set it on top of the unit. But there was a problem. I started looking at my backup jobs and I noticed that they were failing every single night, as you can see. So that was a problem. So you do what everybody should do from the very beginning. I finally come around and do it. Read the manual. Read the compatibility list on Synology's website. Guess what? That drive was too old and it was not compatible with the Synology 1823 XS Plus. So I found a drive that was, and I picked out this Seagate 8 terabyte drive, and I was able to get a really good discount on it from Amazon, and I got two of them for right at $300, and I bought them in February of 2024. It's now March 2024. I noticed they're no longer for sale on Amazon. They may already be out. There are larger drive sizes available, but those aren't listed on the compatibility list for Synology. So as luck would have it, I got the two drives in place and it worked. So what I want to do now is show you basically the unboxing of this Seagate drive and plugging in an external USB drive to the back of the Synology. And I know for some of you, that's really, really basic stuff, but some people need to see how this works. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, we've got the Synology machine taken out and you'll notice that there are two USB connectors on this box. We're going to get our Seagate expansion backup, an 8 terabyte external hard drive. And let's unbox that. Pretty simple. It's straightforward. You've got an external drive with a handy dandy manual that comes with it in case you've never plugged one of these things in. Once we take it out, we're going to take out the other components for this. And other than the USB connector cable, we've got a universal power connector cable. So it comes with a little plastic piece that you take off. And so it starts out with a basic connector there, and you just take out the adapter for the country that matches your power. In my case, the United States. We're just going to slide that over the generic power supply face. And now we are ready to plug things in. There's only two plugs. One of them is the proprietary, it's not a USB, it's a proprietary USB connector. And then you've got a USB-A connector on the other end. There's the back of the unit again for the Synology, and those are the two USB ports. We're going to plug one drive into that, put it on the top, and then we're going to plug the power in. One thing I do want to mention, if you want to get rid of that wall wart, you can buy these small extensions that will eliminate that wall wart and turns it into a regular power connector for your rack. I love that. And there are the units. I actually have two 8 terabyte units plugged in, and there's the back of the unit. And there you go. So now that we've got this set up, we can begin to back up some shared folders that we've set up on the NAS every single night, and hopefully we won't get an error. Let's set that up. Let's open up Hyper Backup, and that's the program that I'm using to make the backup each night. And you can see that it is successful, at least the last time that it ran. I have two, EXT USB 1, EXT USB 2. Those are the two USB hard drives, not hard to figure that out. I'm basically putting some shared folders on one, not all, and then I'm putting the other set of folders on another, and on one I'm backing up some of the programs too. One is going to run at 3 o'clock in the morning, the other is going to run at 2 o'clock in the morning. The two USB external drives show up in the external devices . There is actually a shared folder for each one. And the only thing that is on, it is within these shared folders, is the backup that's running through Hyper Backup each night. Let's open those two up and take a look. One's called USB01HBK, Hyper Backup File. And you can see, the other one is called NAS drive underscore one. Let's go to the scheduler and see it's set to run at 2 o'clock and 3 o'clock. Now, Hyper Backup set up this schedule in the scheduler. I didn't have to do that. And then let's take a look at the log files. And we can see that our backup drive, or backup task, is running successfully each night. And I have verified that's true for USB 1 and 2. So even though my large Synology 1823XS Plus is 76 plus terabytes worth of data, I'm probably only using about 8 to 10 terabytes right now. That will grow over time, but I've now got 16 terabytes of data that I can back up every single night to these external USB drives so that if something were to happen to the NAS, I'm still protected. And if you remember the first video where I set up the NAS, I set it up as RAID 6, so I can still have two drives fail on the Synology NAS, which is better than RAID 5, even though I gave up some space on the Synology NAS for that. So I'm backing up to 16 terabytes on the NAS, and as things change, there may be additional drives that are larger USB external drives that pop up on the compatibility list that take me further down the road and get me much more space than 16 terabytes in the future. Out of my 3-2-1 backup strategy, I have 3 and 2. I still need that one that's external to my site, and we haven't done that yet. And probably in just a few weeks, I'll share my solution to that. Most people would just say, hey, just use the cloud, but I chose a different route. Thank you so much for joining me on this podcast today. If you like what you see on this video, it will be great if you liked and subscribed to the channel. Also, contact me. I'm readily available on most social media networks. LinkedIn is my primary place that I hang out at most of the time because this is mostly around business and software engineering. But you can also send me an email to heyscott@smcjournal.com. Would love to hear from you. Would like to know what you think about these hardware videos that I'm sharing, which is a little bit different than the software engineers. And I promise that we will be getting back to software engineering very, very soon. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you on the next episode. Scott Moore saying bye-bye.